Welcome to Dr. Tom Talks. Today, a special on weight loss drugs, specifically on semaglutide. So you might have heard of Ozempic, you might have heard of Wegovy. That's what I'm going to be talking about. And even more specifically, I'm going to be talking about how they work in the human body with the help of the BioDigital Human. So very quickly, by way of background, Ozempic is a type 2 diabetes medication designed to help type 2 diabetes patients control their blood sugar, but it was found to also cause weight loss. And so it's now been turned into an actual weight loss drug under the name Wegovy, but it's the same drug. It's semaglutide. And it's just a slightly higher dosage in Wegovy, and they're both injectables, and you can inject them yourself once a week. So what did it actually show in this main study that was done on Wegovy, the weight loss drug? About 2,000 individuals took part in this study, and they were obese or they had excess weight with a medical condition. And it was also paired, I have to stress, with a lower calorie diet and exercise. But the overall result is those who took Wegovy as opposed to the placebo, on average, lost 15% of their body weight. And that equated to about 35 pounds. And they were able to keep that off in that 68-week study. I have to say that the starting weight on average was about 232 pounds. So remember, this is for overweight and obese individuals. But let's look into how it actually works in the body. So let's take a look at what happens when you just have, food or drink normally. So you have a sugary drink or you have a meal, goes in your mouth, down your esophagus, into your stomach, and then it's emptied into the small intestine here. Here's the small intestine. Now, this is a totally normal hormone that's produced, GLP-1, when you get food or drink inside your small intestine. Your small intestine releases GLP-1. Now, semaglutide, the drug that is in Wegovy and Ozempic, that is just a synthetic version of GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide 1. That's all it is. It's exactly the same structure. It is just synthetically produced. And so what does glucagon-like peptide 1 or semaglutide do when it enters your body to cause you to perhaps be able to manage your weight better or lose weight? Well, there's three main things that people believe are the root cause here of weight loss. So first of all, it increases insulin and reduces glucagon. So if we zoom into the pancreas here, semaglutide increases insulin. So insulin, remember, reduces your blood sugar levels and it reduces glucagon. Glucagon is meant to raise your blood sugar levels. So you'll end up controlling your blood sugar levels better. Hence, it's also good for people with type 2 diabetes. One of the other things that it does is if you look at the stomach, it actually slows gastric emptying. So we'll zoom into the stomach here, and this is your stomach squeezing, taking the food from your esophagus down to the small intestine. What semaglutide does is it delays that process and it keeps food in your stomach for longer. So you stay fuller for longer and you don't crave your next meal. You don't feel as hungry, sooner after your last meal. And finally, and perhaps most importantly, there's actually an effect on the brain, specifically the hypothalamus. It actually suppresses your hunger cravings in that area. So hunger cravings are mainly hormonal, and it's able to suppress those hunger cravings. So those are the three main mechanisms that we think are at play here that enable some weight loss reduction. Remember, it's really important to speak to a healthcare professional if you're thinking about taking these weight loss drugs, and it must be done in combination with diet and exercise changes. This has been a Dr. Tom Talk. For any more information, please go to biodigital.com.